Hi, my name's Ross Coulthart. I'm an investigative reporter of some 3.5-4 decades experience. I work as an occasional contributory investigative reporter for the Spotlight program on the Seven Network. I've also written for multiple newspapers. I've reported for Four Corners at the ABC, 60 Minutes at Channel 9. I have a long experience in investigative journalism, and I think UFOs, UAPs, need to be taken very seriously indeed. In December 2017, everything changed in the subject of UFOs, because what happened was the New York Times released the first of what eventually became a series of videos that had been recorded by US Navy pilots that had been leaked from within a special secret Pentagon UFO investigation program. And what those videos showed was quite extraordinary. It was paradigm changing because they showed objects clearly detected on radar, seen by pilots, seen by multiple witnesses, following a series of apparently impossible maneuvers. They were doing extraordinary things, anomalous things that were beyond known human science. What they were doing was hypersonic maneuvers, in some cases tens of thousands of kilometers an hour. They were literally turning on a dime, doing instantaneous right-angled turns without any change in velocity or acceleration. They were capable of disguising themselves. They could actually make themselves invisible. They appeared to have the capacity to anticipate and know what the US Navy pilots were talking about or even thinking. Incredibly, there was a thing called the cap point that they were told to return to, the two pilots, after they first engaged with an object that became known as the Tic Tac. And the commander of the squadron, Dave Fravor, was told to return to the cap point, which was about 60 to 70 kilometers distant, closer to the USS Nimitz, the aircraft carrier from which he was based. And even though those coordinates had not been displayed anywhere on the electronic console of his aircraft or by any kind of internal communication system on the plane, somehow the object knew he was returning to his cap point. And when he got back to his cap point, he was told by the USS Nimitz staff that it was there waiting for him. Something was capable intelligently of engaging with these craft. This really is a turning point. And for a while, it was in the mainstream press, and everybody, including debunkers, were basically saying it was all nonsense and these were perfectly explainable videos. And then in about July last year, the US Pentagon came out, and in an unprecedented admission, they basically conceded they could not explain these videos. That was the turning point in the difference between ridiculing UFOs, UAPs, unidentified aerial phenomena, as it's now more politely known, and the more conservative approach that's going now, which is the fact that there are commentators, former CIA directors, politicians, former generals, admirals, people now conceding that whatever this is, it's real. That was a turning point. And this is why it's quite an exciting time, because after years of ridicule, where you get called a tinfoil hat crazy if you talk about UFOs, we now realize the public's actually being manipulated by very devious disinformation folk inside US intelligence. And the big question is why? And so what's exciting is that there are now US congressmen, senators and congressmen, who are pushing for greater transparency. There's a new ghastly acronym, AOIMSG, which is the new office to investigate UFOs inside the Pentagon. But a lot of congressmen and a lot of senators don't think that goes far enough. So they're actually pushing for even greater transparency. There's a proposed amendment called the Gillibrand Amendment, and it's called that because there's a senator called Kirsten Gillibrand, and she's pushing not only for the Pentagon's UFO office, which I suspect is a bit of a fop to try and stop things like Senator Gillibrand's amendment. It's actually pushing for massive amounts of transparency. The Pentagon would be required to regularly report to the Congress, including in a public version of the report, exactly what it knows about UFOs. This would reveal, for example, has the US government, and people are talking about this, has the US government recovered craft? Have they recovered technology that is, quote, not of this world? There are allegations from people, insiders, who claim to be briefed and aware of the issues going on inside government, who claim that the US government is in possession of technology. And believe it or not, there are also people who are asserting that the United States government may very well have recovered biological entities, life forms. These are allegations that have been around on the tinfoil hat conspiracy fringe edge of ufology for many, many years. But now, for the first time, there are people who are actually taking this claim seriously. And the reason it's significant is because back in 2011, under President Barack Obama, the science advisor for the president put out a formal statement on behalf of the US president. And it formally denied, if you like, a cover-up on UAPs. It formally denied that the US was aware of any extraterrestrial visitation to planet Earth or of any knowledge of recovered technology, recovered alien technology. People I'm talking to in the Congress say they're now no longer so sure about that presidential denial. They actually think it's possible that the United States government is in possession of retrieved alien, non-human technology. A wild allegation, still unproven, but here's the moment where it will be put to the test and the Congress will be demanding answers. I do caution also, there is a possibility that the public could well be snowed for another 75 years. Because there has been, I am in no doubt whatsoever, that there has been a very clever cover-up about what the US government in particular knows of the phenomenon for many, many years, decades in fact, since World War II. I'm in no doubt about that based on the conversations that I've had with inside sources, sources I can't reveal, that as a journalist I'm pledged to protect the confidentiality of. But they're telling me things that I find astounding. And if the Congress gets to learn those officially, if the videos are released, if the data is released, the world will change dramatically. We've all been told as journalists that UFOs are nonsense, that it should be treated with ridicule and stigma. And I've never quite understood that because privately, my sources in defense, intelligence, and people who privately study the subject of UFOs, UAPs, they've told me that there is a groundswell, an absolute mountain of evidence on the official record already to substantiate that the phenomenon is real. So that's what my book was about. My book was all about going into this as an investigative journalist, looking at what evidence is there to support the reality of the phenomenon. And I freely admit I went into it very, very skeptical. I did expect to see a lot of the debunker claims about the phenomena proved correct, that, you know, often we misidentify things. And we do. We do often misidentify atmospheric phenomena and think that it's something anomalous. But what was fascinating is that even inside the now declassified files of the US Defense Department, the British Defense Department, and Australia's Defense Department, there are astonishing revelations on the historical record that show we've long been aware of the reality of the phenomenon. It genuinely is unexplained. And then when I started reaching out to people that I thought might know something about this subject matter, people in military, defense, intelligence, they did. And they told me some extraordinary things. And that was the basis for my book, In Plain Sight, available in all good bookshops.